Welcome DMV Lax fans to Triplet Field at Bordley Stadium for the DMV Lax Game of the Week, also known as the Rivalry, featuring the DMV number 4 ranked Landon Bears, who are 6-4, and the DMV number 1 and nationally number 13 ranked Georgetown Prep Little Hoyas, who are 8-2. I'm Calvin Maddox, and thanks for watching this Mad Lax Media live stream production. Joining me today is a very special guest providing expert analysis, Brendan Fry. Brendan is a 1992 graduate of Georgetown Prep, where he was a two-time captain and All-IC and All-Met defenseman. He went on to play at Loyola, where he was a three-time All-American and captain. He was also named into the Georgetown Prep Hall of Fame in 2014. Thanks for joining me today, Brendan.
Absolutely, Cabell. Thank you for having me.
Fired up to have you on board today.
Does it get any better, man? Friday afternoon, the greatest rivalry in high school sports, 35 years, 35-year anniversary. Throw out the records. This is as good as it gets.
I agree. Prep travels to 6101 Wilson Lane here today to take on a very hot Bears team who has just upset Bullis last week and beat a very solid Cardinal Gibbons team from North Carolina this week. The Little Hoyas are, after being upset at home 6-5 last spring by the Bears, look to avenge that disappointing loss with a win here today. Prep, who has also been on Easter break and hasn't played for 8 days, is the heavy favorite. A minus 4.5 spread for those at home for fun, and has won 5 games in a row, including a big DMV win over number 3 ranked Gonzaga. The history of this game is unmatched, Brendan, with Coach Bordley, Rob Bordley, and Kevin Giblin, the two former longtime legendary head coaches who set the tone and created this healthy rivalry that is surely one of the best in the nation to this day. No matter the records, just like you said, or talent levels on each team, viewers can expect a close battle of two of the most consistently dominant programs in the DMV and the country for the last 30 plus years.
Absolutely. These guys all play club lacrosse together, and I realize that club today is a very big part of the game, but you got, guess what? No friends on this field today. You'll be friends right after this game. Hate to lose. Hate to lose today.
Make sure you check out dmvlacrosse.com for full predictions, previews, spreads, and more. Also, if you're watching us live right now on YouTube, you can get the rosters by clicking below in the description of both teams. Let's get right to the sports automotive players to watch. For Landon, Chase Robertson, the Utah commit, the midfielder, Anthony Panetti, attackman, Bucknell commit, and Will Cohen, the Dartmouth commit on defense. For Georgetown Prep, Larry Hornig, the middie, a Georgetown commit, Nathan Kabiri, and Colin Burns, both Princeton commits. You have anything to say about those young men, Brendan?
I mean, all killers, snipers. Snipers, don't give them time and space, I'll give you that much. Let's get it all, man. Doesn't get any better than this.
Here we go, starting lineups coming out. Look for on attack for Landon, Steele Maddox, Anthony Panetti, and Sean Murray. At midfield, Chase Robertson, Anthony Savoy, and Troy Ulisney. Defense, Nico Shermer, Will Abramson, and Will Cohen. Got to keep an eye on Davis Owens. He's been arguably the best LSM in the DMV. Face-off guys, Talon Smith and Hayden Goose. And in goal, Zach Abramson is going to get the start, and he's been playing great of late. For Prep, the dangerous attack trio, Nathan Kabiri, Colin Barbecue Burns, and Owen Horning. At midfield, Larry Horning, Tommy Arata, a first-team All-DMV selection.
Tough kid.
And Rafe Bradshaw. On defense, it's going to be Kelly. It's going to be Ryan Welgos, the Villanova commit, and Isaiah Rose, the Army commit. Luke Crow will get the nod at LSM with Jax Lou facing off, and Jack Cass, the Canadian Marquette. And here we go.
Man, I got chills. Let's get it on.
Let's go.
As good as it gets.
DMV Lax fans, thanks for joining us here today. We're out there shaking hands. It's always like a little bit of a stare down
there. It is. This is a test right here. This is a test. Who's going to blink first, right? Look at Coach Kubik. Coach Kubik coached at Prep for 15 years. He's running the offense with Landon.
How do you feel about that?
I got to be honest. Benedict Arnold, my man. Benedict Arnold. We love him. But tough to see him head over there.
He coached defense for those years. He was coaching offense.
Literally. Yeah, I think maybe he's a plant.
Yeah. All right, here we go. Just something predicted. We got Nathan Ferguson on the wing. Talon Smith facing off, Jax Lou, Larry Horning on the wing for
watch his kid crow. He's a face
off
athlete.
Pitch and pop for Jax Liu. He's got a fast break down to left side. Picked off by Davis Owen.
Dude, great get in the hole.
Arguably the best
LSM
in the area, as we mentioned in the pregame. He's having a season, number 13.
Great hustle.
13.
Getting your stick in the lane.
Over to Will Cohen. Send it to clear. Over to Chase Robertson. Little head fake and goes by Owen Horning. Landon quickly forces a turnover and gets their first possession. Trots out the first midfield. That's Anthony Savoy with the ball. The Denison commit. Out comes Troy Lisney, who had 3 goals and 1 assist against Bullis last week. He's got the hot hand.
Listen, let's be
honest.
And
they're short-sticking
It's an easy game, man. Matchups. Beat your man. Beat your man. Draw a slide. Either shoot and score or pass for a feed. And it's going to be all about matchups. Who shuts it down? Who steps up?
Looks like they're double pulling the middies. Good look by Murray to the backside at Robertson. Little hitch.
Good side.
Down the alley. Blasted it. Whoa, hit his own guy at X. So it didn't go out of bounds or else it would have been.
Good ground ball.
Nice
tough ground ball. Ground ball is going to be everything.
Larry Horning.
Good
Horning
ground
got
ball,
the field.
Man.
They have a fast break.
Man, rumbling.
Fast break. Larry Horning blasts.
Oh, stood right up to that shot.
Easy
stood
save.
Right
it's
up to that shot.
Outlet.
Can of corn. We got to get a little heat. Change.
To the point to Panetti. Oh, what a save by Jack Cass.
Two great saves to start the game.
Wow.
Goalies are confident early. Goalies are going to step up. I love to see it, man.
This that tempo first is save, right out of the gate hot.
That first save gives you a lot of confidence. It's going to be great.
Here's Jack Cass pushing the energy here on the face. Up to 13. He throws it away. Too much juice.
Man, that's Coach Borley. That's Coach Borley right there. Ride.
Yeah.
Ride. If you ain't riding, you're sitting on the sideline. If you ain't riding, you're sitting on the sideline. Get the ball back.
I mean, the juice level right now is 10.
Feels
it's
good.
A 10.
It's
both
good.
Teams are firing. Both goalies are huge early saves.
Huge early saves.
Whoa. Chase picked up tight there by number one, Carson Whittier.
Carson Whittier, tough kid, scrappy.
And Chase is drawing, Robertson's drawing the short stick. He needs to exploit that. He hasn't gotten a short stick all season. They're double pulling the middies with Wellghost, the Villanova commit, and Crow.
Yeah, I like this kid
Crow's
Crow.
Crow's a Notre Dame commit.
Yeah, I like this kid Crow. I've seen him from a little bit of a distance. Lived on Glenridge Street. Tough Kensington kid. He's got some scrap to him.
Oh, I thought they were in zone for a second. My bad. They're still a man-to-man. A little invert here. Chase Robertson. Can't believe he has a short stick. They have a slide ready, though. Great out. Great pass to Savoy. Landon trying to figure out, I think, what they're in. Nice sneak there by Robertson. He drops the pass. Cass picks
there
it up.
Is. Tough look feeding the crease like
here's
that.
Here's Will Keegan.
Here we go.
Up to Crow.
I like this kid.
No numbers
I
here,
I like
though.
This kid.
Landon's back.
Take it to the hole. Oh, go get oxygen. You earned it, my man. I ain't running that far and
he
not
got
shooting.
Backed up by Abramson, the WNL commit. Oh, no, not, my bad, sorry. Horning picks it up. I thought White backed that up, but it's prep. If you haven't noticed, if you're just joining us, we have Brendan Fry here in the house here with me, Cabo Maddox. Brendan Fry is a prep alum, so we're not trying to be objective
here. We're Denmark and Norway.
That was a push, no call. So the refs have it. Oh, moving pick there.
Let him play. Come
two,
on, man.
Two no calls there, setting the tone. Up to Patrick Kelly. So this sophomore beat out a lot of outstanding juniors.
Yeah.
Whoa, that was a risky pass, and it still is a risky pass. You're not going to...
Just get out of there.
Jack Cass.
Royal and Dervish. Come on. Run away from pressure.
Tommy Arata.
Tough little kid.
Tommy
North Potomac.
Tommy Arata is just made an elite-level play there. I mean, he was thrown into three guys.
Yeah. I'm telling you, I saw him last night. Kid's a killer.
Not the best clear, but they got away with it because they have athletes like Arata. Here's Horning. Larry Horning. Look at the violence behind the goal.
I know.
Oh, it's the pipe. Larry Horning.
Goalie's best friend.
Question mark there. Outside roll.
Yeah,
I agree. Nice dodge there by Larry Horning. Here's Barbecue Burns on Nico Schirmer.
He's got a chip right now, I'm telling you. After last year's loss.
Oh!
Boom. Listen, Princeton take tough kids too, man. That kid is a gamer.
First goal of the day unassisted.
By Colin Burns.
1-0 prep here with 8 minutes to go in the first period.
His dad, I played with his uncle. His uncle was a SEAL Team 6 doctor and was on a ton of missions. He was our face-off guy, absolute killer. Chris Burns.
You played with him at prep?
Played with him at prep. He's a faceoff guy.
All right, so now the prep fans, the student body's here, and now we hear some energy. Good faceoff there by Talon Smith. Where's the ball?
Here we go.
The ball picked up behind the play by number 29, Nathaniel McQueen.
Speed.
All right, now Barbecue Burns settles him down. Colin Burns, nicknamed Barbecue by the legendary Chris Remington, and we refer to him as Barbecue for you friends at home. That is Colin Burns, number zero. Here is 55, Wyatt Bowman.
I know it's early, but this is a big stand because you do not want, prep is counting on going out fast and hard early. You do not want to let them get a run here, I'm telling
you. Big kid, but Christian debuted on him. Very, very large sophomore.
They've grown bigger these days, don't they?
He's only a sophomore.
they're growing bigger these days.
Here's Burns over to McCleary. McCleary, the Hopkins commit down the alley. Offhand, he's a lefty.
He's got to get that stick a little wet.
Landon's pulling him, which is smart, in the second line with Harrison Hall. Here's Kabiri with Will Cohen on him. Will Cohen is one of the better athletes in Dartmouth.
He really is, man. Can I tell you something? I love his footwork. And just beat him to goal line, extend him, turn him back.
Bowman driving on Damian. He's got a little bit of size. Here's Horning with Abramson.
I love this kid. I love this family.
Owen Horning. Backside wrap.
You want to catch tuna and score some goals? You count on a Horning, I'll tell you that much. Woo!
Number seven. Unassisted 1v1. If it's going to be a 1v1 game, then Prep's going to win.
Matchups.
Then Prep's going to win.
Matchups.
And that's already two goals.
Matchups.
We didn't have a chance to get to the keys to the game. We're going to get to the keys to the game beforehand for both the coaches and us. But one of the keys was for Landon was limiting this dangerous attack, and they already have two goals.
Yeah.
2-0.
Yeah. Prep. They need a face-off win here and a good possession. Calm it down a little bit because this game is going to be runs. It's going to be runs.
They called a foul on that cross check. Tough call.
Who?
On Landon.
Wow, Frank Boyle. Look at him out there making that call.
That was I don't think it was him. I think it was the far side ref who.
Okay.
I don't even think it was a foul, to be honest with you. I'm not watching replay or anything, but I thought it was a little soft of a cross check.
Well, I will give him a hard time when he's playing poker congressional on Monday. I'll make sure that he knows that was soft.
Yes,
that was soft. Because I always I'm a defenseman, Cabell. You know that I come in the side of defenseman. Yeah. Doesn't matter what color they wear.
Trust me, I felt your hammer hacks.
Yes,
I felt your hammer hacks. That was a light call, but regardless, Landon is facing off man down, and they're down 2-0. This is a bad situation for Landon. And Jax Liu is dominating faceoffs.
Oh,
nice little play there,
silky
by Thomas Yavinsky.
That was silky.
And they get a timeout. Timeout, Urich. Scott Urich calls timeout with possession with 6:29 to go.
Boys are juiced today. Boys are juiced today. This is going to be a great rival. The best part about it is we know this game's going to come down last few minutes.
Let's get to the keys to victory here. For Landon first, containing their dangerous attack trio with the three seniors on defense. And the Landon defense did a great job against Bullish. You can see this is a different level here tonight. Forced their middies to do it all. Two, 55% or better for faceoffs and saves. And then three, score some unscripted goals. Score some ride goals and transition goals. For prep, and this is big, I know you were with the team last night, overcome that 8-day layoff for Easter and start fast.
Absolutely.
Two, attack must continue scoring dominance, and they're off to a 2-0 lead. And three, utilize the depth. I thought it was going to be hotter today. It's probably only about 75, but it's a beautiful day.
It is.
And the crowd is coming in heavy. It looks like we already have about maybe 1,500 people here. Expect the crowd to swell to 2,500.
It's funny, Cabell. You and I have been coming here for 25, 30 years, and this is the environment that I remember. This is whether I was playing football here or playing lacrosse here. This is just one of the greatest DC sporting events there is for high school sports.
I
love it.
No question. And these guys might have to play each other again in the
absolutely
in the playoffs. They play each other at least twice a year, most years. And Landon's coming up man up. It looks like Ferguson's shutting off Kabiri. So they're going to play 5-on-4 lacrosse. Now they're shutting off Arata. A little flip-flop on the shutoff.
Yeah.
Good defensive strategy by Coach Cassidy.
I mean, exactly. I think Kabiri is the known entity, but Arata is the killer.
Now they're shutting off Kabiri. So they're going 5-on-4 and making it difficult on prep as they can, and now he's going to go shut up somebody else. Kabiri shoots it 30 and steals. 5-10, 15.
That's a tough shot. Offside, offside by his foot.
16.
That is a tough shot at Heat.
16 yarder.
Shot had some pace, man. Shot had some pace.
That's
yeah, I thought that call was soft. Let's have the refs let the guys play the game, right? That was a soft call. You know?
Yeah, and that Zach's got it. You know, that's off stick because he's a lefty, so that's a great shot by Kabiri.
Exactly. That's like perfect placement. And that's years of practice, right? That's years of practice. It's muscle memory. He just fires it, and it goes exactly where the goalie stick is.
They call it unreleasable? That was an unreleasable?
Did they really?
Yeah. Wow. Still man up. Wow. 30 seconds to go, and the man up. 6-11 to go. Jax Lou flips it back off the faceoff. That's released. It's in the box. Lou Crow picks it up. Steel Maddox in the mix there. And Prep comes up with it. Ball's bouncing Prep's way. Jax ball Lou straight. Gets his own ground ball. Number 21, Jax Lou. Down to Owen Horning. Owen Horning up. And they're still man up. They're going to have another man up opportunity here.
What did they get? 2 minutes?
No, they just got 1 minute, but it was unreleasable. Nice. 10 seconds in the man up. Looks like they're not going to run a play.
Oh, God.
Unless they can squeeze it out here. Kieran McCleary comes in. Wide open Burns.
Wow.
I mean, Landon's the scramble.
Boys are fired up.
That's a nightmare penalty.
That is a nightmare penalty for Landon. They need a face-off here. They need some offensive time of possession.
They need a timeout. And they still have to face off man down because they scored with 1 second to go. So they can't even release the guys on the out on the field until someone gets the ball. So let's see. Landon hasn't won a face-off. Jax Lou's doing a great job on face-offs. Won every single one. Four face-offs already, and he's won every one. And he wins it again. Man, he has got a power clamp. That guy. Jax Lou is a nice transfer in the boarding school from St. Chris Jr. Just dominating with that power.
Where's that? St. Chris? Richmond?
Richmond. He's a Richmond boy. Look at the size of his legs. He looks like he weighs about 220.
Yeah.
And now it's all even. Landon hasn't released it yet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, it's all even. Sorry. Yeah, it's all even. 5:16 to go here. Last goal was scored by Sport Automotive Player to Watch. Colin Barbecue Burns.
High to high, high heat.
Nice ground ball there by Eli.
Great ground ball.
First positive
run
play
it out.
For Landon in a while. This is a sophomore. He doesn't see any daylight. Runs himself into trouble.
All right, makeup call. But that's all right, makeup call. Listen.
But that was a moving screen they called after the ball.
It's a makeup call. I promise you, he didn't go to Prep with me, but that's a makeup call. He's getting on a plane.
Here comes Landon, first possession. Landon,
keep some possession here.
Landon needs a goal desperately. 4:40 to go here in the first period. 4-0 Prep. Good energy here.
Dude, this kid Crow is tough as nails, man.
88.
Yeah. Wiry.
Notre Dame
tough.
Commit.
Yeah.
Here's a Ryan Wells.
He's going to do great out there.
Commit. Looks like they're short-sticking one of the attackmen with Bradshaw, Rafe Bradshaw, the Tampa commit down on an attackman.
Tampa.
This is
now that's where I wish I went to play lacrosse. Tampa. That sounds great.
I've been to
that
campus.
That
it's
sounds
on the
beautiful.
Beach.
I know, exactly. Was in Baltimore.
Is Prep and man-to-man, Fry?
Yes.
It looks like they're in a pseudo man-to-man.
I got to be honest. If they go to zone, I might go down there and fire the coach because we don't play zone at Prep. We play man-to-man. That's what we do as far as I'm concerned.
Here's Troy Lisney. Split left. Nice forces inside. Not a good pass. Steel Maddox on the pickup. Steel Maddox drives left, has Isaiah Rose on him. Here's Anthony Panetti. Here's a wide open shot.
Whoa!
There we go. 11.
Woo!
Chase Robinson from Anthony Panetti. That's two of the players, Sport Automotive players to watch.
I'm telling you, that's why the girls like goal scorers. High to high, 100 miles an hour. That thing had some heat on
Landon
it.
Landon gets on the board there. Sport Automotive.
No change of direction. Goalie, stop me. Try to stop me. And you can't. I liked it.
Absolute.
I liked
cannon
it.
Cannon to top left. I think that's stick side high. I think Jack's a righty. Jack Cass, the Coquitlam, British Columbia product boarding student. And Landon wins the first face.
Oh. Game of runs, man. Game of runs.
First face-off win.
Game of runs.
Oh, I thought he threw that. And he throws it away. Man. What just happened? Sorry, I was looking.
I missed it. Yeah, same. Quick start.
Quick restart. That must not have ever gone out of bounds. Here's Kabiri. has Ferguson on him. I was looking down there. Were you paying
attention? I wasn't.
I thought the ball went out of bounds. I was going to take a quick note, and I look up, and someone's on their back.
My attention was somewhere else, but yes. All right, number eight. We love eight.
Eight is Harrison Hall.
I love it.
Harrison Hall is a
senior. He's a neighbor, great kid, going to Michigan next year.
Oh, he is?
Just a great kid.
Looks like a fast.
Plays the sax. That looked a little bit like a holdie.
And they don't even call that. And they call it in the crease. Now you might be seeing a makeup call there. Harrison Hall, Michigan, but he's...
Oh, we're going to do great together. We are absolutely on the same page. I absolutely agree.
I mean, that was a pretty good hold there by Cohen. Maybe he released his hands. Who knows? It wasn't that big of a hole. But. And here comes the second line for the first time out with Quinn Coughlin, the high Wesleyan commit, Devin Stewart, and this is Caden Southworth, both sophomores.
Got to push him down the side. Don't let him in the middle.
He's got well ghosts on him. This is not the best matchup.
Get in his hands.
Ryan Welgo's plays for me at Madlax. He is a phenomenal one-on-one defenseman. Here's Anthony Panetti, quick as a cat. Over to Devin Stewart, has Luke Crow on him. Stewart has good steps. Down to Maddox. Maddox has a short stick on him. He should look to dodge. Throws the ball away to Murray.
Nice clear.
Quick clear there by Jack Bass up to number 10, McCleary. Down to Burns. Burns with the leg drip. Full leg, left leg drip. What do you think about that left leg look?
I'm old school, man. I don't even wear arm pads. Just go out there, put on a helmet, and go. That's my thing.
The Coach Kubik down here yelling at the guys, that bring back some memories.
Yeah, he is one of the greatest men, but also just a great coach. And Landon it was an incredible steal. We miss him terribly, but you know, he always has a home.
So after coaching for Kevin Giblin, he went to Churchill for 5 years, but also coached. There's Larry Hornig.
You see, they're going left. They're literally going low left. Scouting report, go low, you know, offside.
15, Larry Hornig, the Georgetown commit, one-on-one down the alley. Just buries it, and it's 5-1 here. Still in the first quarter with 1 minute to go. This is getting out of hand and a nightmare for Coach McGettigan and the Landon staff. Yeah. No timeouts or anything to slow them down.
Yeah, you're exactly right. An early start for prep. This doesn't look great right now. But I do believe it's a game of runs.
And Jax Lew is absolutely, why'd he throw that? He could have gotten a fast break. He is just killing. 7-1 on faceoffs already.
Kabiri plays with confidence. Just, I love it.
Oh,
you play with confidence. One-handed, exactly.
Really?
The 2 years together, they not out.
They're going to play the next floor.
Exactly. Listen.
And they got Tucker Wade from Bullis, who's joining them too. Another elite attackman.
Yeah,
Three DMV guys in Princeton. That makes, you know, DMV.
Yeah, unfortunately, they didn't choose Loyola. We didn't get them. But,
Wyatt Bowman, one-on-one. Absolute bloodbath. Wyatt Bowman, number 55, the sophomore. Unknown entity no longer. Obviously earned himself a spot on the second line and scoring there. Listen, I write down notes after every single play. Every single goal, except for one on EMO, was a one-on-one dodge. You don't want to get into a one-on-one with prep.
Matchups.
They could be number one in the country if you want to play that
much. We talked about it last night. We talked literally matchups. The game is easy. And in the old days, we got our butts kicked because Landon had the matchups. Today, I think prep has the matchups, so Landon needs to play kind of a slower ball control game.
All right, 25 seconds to go. Sean Murray with the ball has Kelly on him. A lot of intensity in this game. I'm not sure many of the Landon boys are ready for this. Skip inside.
Good check. Get on his hands right there when the pass is thrown.
3 seconds, and that's going to end the quarter. An absolute destruction. 6-1 after one. Not pretty for the Bears here at Triplett Field at Bordley Stadium. Coach Bordley is in the house here today.
Oh, he is?
Yeah, he always floats around. He's on a golf cart somewhere.
It's a great story. That man got me into college. This is a great story.
Tell that quick story.
1990, we came up here. I don't even think Prep gave us a bus to drive in here. We drove our own cars, and we looked like Jim Dandy and the Fudge Along Gang walking in here, wearing different jerseys, different helmets. Johnny Keenan had a red helmet on, and we had Homer Thompson and Taylor Simmers and Clay Curtis and just a bunch of killers on that team. And we hold the game to 5-3 over here in the dustbin, on right here on Wilson Lane.
Yeah.
We used to call it the Massacre on Wilson.
Yeah.
The Massacre at White Rocks, right? And so we held it, we lost 5-3, and Borley calls Coach Cottle Loyola and says, I don't know if this kid can read or write, but he runs like the wind and he'll mash your face in. And all of a sudden, I wasn't going to Delaware Tech, I was going to Loyola. And that's a great thing.
That's nice. That's awesome. All right, let's show the sponsors. I want to put a special thank you out to Sport Automotive and to Surfside Grill. Our guys down there picking up this game. Really, really generous of Sport Automotive. They're bringing you the players to watch. Sport Automotive, Chevrolet, Cadillac, and Honda. Be a sports fan too and visit sportautomotive.com. Be sure to ask for our friend and Sport Automotive owner, Gibbs Fogarty, a Landon 01 graduate, 05 graduate, when you visit Sport. I think if you tell them that you hate Prep, you might get a heavy discount on a car up there.
Yeah, I pay full price every time I go over there. It's wild.
You should. They should double the price for you up there at Sport Automotive. Back here in the second quarter. Thanks for joining us. I'm Cabo Maddox here with Brennan Fry.
Doesn't get any better. Crowd's filling in. We got a bunch of proms tonight. Everybody's here.
Yeah, Holy Child tonight.
And
Stone Ridge tomorrow night.
Yeah.
You were that guy probably that went to both proms
back
to back.
Well, listen, I'm going to have to sneak out of here too because my daughter's a junior at Holy Child, Annie Fry. She's my little angel, and she's going with a good counsel guy. I got to go shake his hand, look him in the eyes, and let him know for 16 years I protected her. Now it's his turn, and she better have her home by 11:30.
How many guys here are sprinting off the field to get to the Holy Child prom tonight?
It's going
to
be, I'm telling you, there's going to be a hurry because pictures are important apparently.
Here's Anthony Savoy, the dentist to commit with Whittier on him. Back at X to Panetti. Landon looks a little more settled here. Murray just
gave his body up. That's what this rivalry is about, man. That guy just dove in there, took the hit.
He got hit in the head by a Rose from X on a quick slide across. Yeah. We're gonna go man up.
So I met Isaiah yesterday. I've not met him before. And his mom, he's going to West Point next year. When you talk about guys you want to defend our country, Isaiah Rose is that type of guy. I'm not kidding you.
Definitely.
He's a gentleman. He is. And I told him, take it easy on Loyola Patriot League guys, and Army's been beating us up lately. I said, man, take it easy.
I saw his dad before the game.
He's a great, great kid.
Awesome kid. Played for Madlax,
yes.
DC Dogs,
love
23.
It. Love it.
So did half of the 23s on this field here today. Played for Coach Rienzo and the 23 DC Dogs. Man up opportunity
this
here.
Is big. This
first
is big.
Man up.
Landon needs
for
one here.
Landon. Prep scored on their first man up opportunity of the day. Actually, sorry, they scored two on that one, on that unreleasable.
Yeah, soft, soft.
Did they call unreleasable on that?
It should have been. If they called on the last one, that should have been.
Because that was a nice hit to the head, and I'm glad Murray's okay. Here's Savoy. Man, heavy pressure on man down. It feels a bad. Isaiah Rose just forced a turnover down.
They're playing confident. You know what I'm saying? In football, they say it's pinning your ears back. They're playing confident right now. Landon's got to get a couple goals here, slow it down, because Prep's playing pretty loose.
I mean, they're pressing out all over the field and man down. That's just knows you're another level. Who's the defensive coordinator for Prep? I know that Young Horning coaches the offense. I don't know who coaches the defense, do you?
I don't. But I got to give him credit, man. He's done a great job. Kids are playing loose.
Is it Chris Hampton or CJ Carpenter?
Chris.
Yeah, Chris. Okay, Chris Hampton.
And
they're
playing loose, but they're playing with intensity, right? They're playing with purpose. And that's what you want.
I mean, pressing out a man down is a little risky, but it paid off there.
I totally agree. By the way, man down was when I used to rest. Give me an oxygen machine. That's when I took a break. I ain't pressing out on anybody on man down.
Here's Ray Bradshaw, the Tampa commit. Back to Horning. Owen Horning has Will Abramson on him. Gets a step on, no shot. Back to his brother, Larry Horning, with Ferguson on him. Ferguson, the Delaware commit. one of the better short stick D middies in the area. Here's Larry on him. Ferguson's a three-sport athlete, the quarterback of the football team.
Oh, wow.
Good defense there.
Great defense there. Make him move the ball.
Only a junior.
Oh, wow.
Here's Kabiri with AZ on him. AZ goes BTB.
Yeah, he gave it up. There's only 3 seconds left in the clock. He gave it up.
Oh, good call.
Wasn't being a showboat there. I didn't know. Because I would have sat his
ass. Oh, nice pass up the field. Robertson and Landon has a pure fast break. Yeah, a 5-on-3. Kick it to the point.
Fire.
No.
Oh.
He should have probably gone to the point on that.
Look at that, man. That's prep Landon right there.
Yeah.
All out. Love it.
I think Chase wanted one there, but I think Panetti had the point wide open. You go to the point guy on that, you get an easier step down instead of a goalie looking at you the whole time as you run down the field. Good location on the shot, but you want to hit the point on that. All right, but this is where Chase is dangerous. Chase Robertson is very good from
behind
the
goal. Man, I'm telling you, any defense.
The Utah commit.
I remember this. This is, you're calling a man out right here. You're saying, I'm going to take you to the cage. Let's see what happens.
Prep is pre-slided. They have a pre-hot guy. Ulisny with Isaiah Rose on him.
Man, the defense moving.
Blast yeah. by Robertson.
Great save by Cash. Yes, that was a great save.
And they set their clear. And here's Keegan.
Keegan going to Notre Dame next year. Smart as a whip.
Oh, he got
great
in,
kid,
he got
great
in?
Parents. Yep.
Oh, that's fantastic. Yeah, Keegan twins are awesome.
Yeah, they are. Yeah, they are.
Love the Keegan family, and that is good to hear. I did not know that news. So you got Hall going to Michigan and Keegan going to Notre Dame. Not to play, but on academics alone,
yes,
that's
exactly.
just impressive. Out comes the second line here for
good D, good D. Kept him out in the middle.
Pushed out to Harrison Hall. Back to
this is Cohen right here.
Barbecue.
This is Cohen right here. Good. Good. Goal line extended. Push it back. Stay on him. Get lower. He got too high. He got up on his shoulder. You dip the shoulder there. He's going to turn the corner.
That's Nico Schirmer. He's going to Bowdoin next year. Oh, behind the back shot. You're always going to get some. You're always going to get some razzle dazzle with Kabiri.
Yeah.
I think there's a call. Is there a flag down? 7:43 to go. 6-1 prep. Refs are discussing something here. Not sure what they were going to call. No call. They're calling. Oh, they're discussing who was out of bounds on. It is a tip ball, so it's back to prep. Little pick there. Little rub there. Cohen on Kabiri.
What's this? Man on man right there. Wow. That's man on man challenge. We talked about matchups. He said, mano a mano, who's going to prom?
And that's the first time Coles would be. Timeout. I guess that's a Landon timeout, but the referee didn't signal. But we'll just assume that's a Landon timeout. Want to make sure everybody listening knows about the official post-game party at Surfside DC down in Tenley Town. Surfside is an official sponsor of this game. So make sure you head down to Surfside. Quick drive here from the stadium. I think it's going to be all prep after this game.
Got to be honest.
Looking right now.
Hey, Bo, can I get some free tacos, man? Jeez, I'm lightheaded up here. I'm in enemy territory. I'm calling this game. Can I get some free tacos? 6 months. Give me 6 months of free tacos.
I think that they might have the game on in Millie's and Surfside right now. So head down to Surfside and enjoy some fajitas after the game, maybe some cervezas. And we want to thank Bo Blair, a prep alum.
What year was Bo Blair? The class of 1990, that class had Kevin Plank, it had Johnny Dessler, who owns the biggest restaurant and bar down in at Ole Miss, Oxford, Mississippi. It had Trip Rogers, who's here today. It had Bo. And they called that class a hard class. And that class is a bunch of absolute killers.
Murderers. Those guys proved them wrong.
Yeah, they did.
Heck of a class.
They did.
Thank you, Surfside and Bo Blair, for sponsoring this event.
Thanks,
here we go.
Bo.
Back to the face-off. 7-1, 7:32 to go. Face-off, pinch and pop, forward by Hayden Goose, but Hayden Goose was held, and they call it, picked up by Yavinsky, but it's going to go back to Landon on the hold on the face-off there by Hayden Goose. Landon gets a rare faceoff win, only their second of the day. Jack Slew just dominating faceoffs. And here they go again, double pulling the mids, short sticking Steele Maddox down there with Whittier. Steele's got to go one-on-one against Carson Whittier.
And you got to beat your man. Beat your man. Here, yeah, don't give it up.
Here he is right here. Let's see if he initiates. So here he is. He's taking him behind. This is going to be...
Here it is.
A little one-on-one, mano-a-mano. Steele takes him right. Maddox draws a slide. Did his
nice.
Job.
Did he got his job.
A little
yeah.
faster. Inside look.
Oh,
nice
guys.
Look by
Maddox. Got to finish that. Got to finish that. I know it's tough.
Maddox. Oh, the ball didn't go out of bounds. It hung up on the end line. Tough situation there. The ball was like 1 inch out of bounds.
Yeah,
had
yeah,
to play
yeah,
it.
Yeah.
Rose picks it up. Great play.
They
got to
finish
Rose.
That on the doorstep. I know it's tough. You got sticks flying all over the place, but you got to finish that on the doorstep in this game.
Okay, just on sides there. I thought
give your defense
there.
A break.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah. Nice clear by prep. Ryan Welgos down to who is that way over there? Burns. All you got to do is look for the white leg drip on the lefty side. We're going to have to get a story on that.
We are. We have to find out.
He had the rec specs last year.
It's definitely coming from the SEAL teams. I'm telling you, that's where it's coming from, Uncle Chris.
Is he wearing the rec specs last year? They made him famous. Yeah. ECD did a spotlight
Kurt
on
Kurt Rambis. Yeah. Kurt Rambis for the Lakers.
I'm not sure he's wearing them this year, but now he's got the lefty leg drip. Here we go. Over to Larry Hornig. Swim move.
Yeah, swim move.
Underneath.
Good slide.
Draws two. Easy
fire
step
it.
Down for Arada.
Oh.
Tommy Arada, the Colgate commit.
He was posing. He was posing. He looked like Tiger on 16 at Augusta. He was posing just a little high.
I thought that he would have that one. And here's Burns with Nico Schirmer, the Bowden commit. Kicks it outside.
Fire it.
Step down Larry Hornet. What a rip there.
Woo!
8-1 prep. 15 from zero on a skip. First non-one-on-one goal.
That'll get you a few likes on Instagram. High heat. Right off hip, changing planes. Learned that the first game. His dad taught him that when he was 8 years old.
Hey, make sure you stick with us. Don't go to the golf or whatever. There's nothing on off. Stick with us. Landon is going to make. This is the rivalry.
This is
okay,
the rivalry.
So maybe 8-1 with 5:44 to go in the second. But hopefully you're enjoying this live stream telecast. Fast break. Luke Crow, Notre Dame commit. Bang. Man, that's shocking that wasn't a goal. They're just overpowering Landon.
Yeah.
Overpowering Landon. And this is the best I've seen prep.
They came with a purpose today.
They were angry about losing last year.
Yeah, they were angry about losing last year. They had 21 seniors on this team. A lot of them going to college. But these boys last night said, we ain't leaving here with a loss.
Tell the story that you were over in the locker room two nights ago, or maybe it was last night. Tell the story about that video that they showed to get the boys hyped.
Oh, it's amazing. So Patrick Caulfield and his brother Paul, who was my year at prep, the first 14 years of this rivalry was an absolute disaster. Every time we came here, we got our teeth kicked in. I mean, it was literally like JV playing varsity every time. We talk about matchups today. They had the matchups every time. And we had 14 years of losses. And Boardley had our number. Coach Woolley had our number, and he had Kevin's number, but we laid a foundation, we kept working, we kept grinding, and in 2004, the Brahma Bull, John Bennett, a Princeton All-American and a Hall of Famer at Georgetown Prep, literally 6'4", gorgeous hair, running down the field, just firing high-to-high shots, long pole. I got to be honest, it was great for me. I loved to watch it.
Yeah.
And he came in here in 2004 and pulled off the first win, and since then, it has been pretty even back and forth, and that's what Landon Prep Lacrosse is all about.
Then that was the game that was...
There you go.
Nice
there you go.
There, who
there
was
you
that?
Go.
Quinn Coughlin, the senior, going to Ohio Wesleyan with a one-on-one goal there.
We talked about one-on-one matchups, Cabell. That was a one-on-one matchup that he went to the cage and said, you're not stopping me today.
My favorite part of that story is when there was a ground ball over on the sidelines, and there were so many Landon Prep fans they came down and they got in his face and
you're talking about 5,000 people at these games, and I know today, but it's more spread out because we're in a stadium atmosphere. Up there on the dirt field, it was just the best. You had 10 deep of everybody in the area, and if you got pushed out of bounds, you got beers dumped on you, you got drinks dumped on you, you got everything, so you didn't ever want to get pushed out of bounds.
Steele Maddox picks up the ball, makes a nice play there on the restart. 4:07 to go, 8-2 Landon. See if they get anything cooking here. Steele draws a shorty again. He beat Whittier last time, drew a slide. Let's see if he does it again. That's got to get the offense going with, got to draw a slide and move the ball. It's a simple game. Right now, Prep is just faster everywhere, winning the one-on-ones all over the place, and just not, Landon's just not defending anyone in one-on-one matchups.
That's
almost a foul, but good no call there. Kickback, they got numbers
here. One more.
Inside.
Oh.
That is excellent. Excellent lacrosse there by 18 from 22, right?
That was great ball movement. Great ball movement.
That was the best ball movement goal of the day.
Talking about not panicking, slow and steady. That was great ball movement.
I mean, they moved five passes and got it inside. It was Panetti, who's got excellent vision. The Bucknell commit, 22, number 22, Anthony Panetti. Inside to Savoy, quickly finishes. It was the other way around, actually. Sorry.
All right, Prep's got a stiff in their back right now because they got a little bit of a rally here, getting some energy here for Landon. They come in and pipe one here, and we got a game again heading into halftime.
Yeah, 8-3, Landon.
8-4, we got a game again because make it, totally. Take it in lacrosse.
Totally, yeah. So Landon up, down 3-8, 3:26 to go here. Look, they know their matchups. Troy, they're shading his left. He is a lefty. Outside high dodge.
Here we go. Mono-e-mono. Who's the man?
He runs right by Keegan. Quick slide there by Kelly. Backside to Panetti. Panetti fades it up to Ulisney. To Robertson.
Man,
the ball movement's excellent
moving the ball,
right now.
They're moving the ball.
Playing better.
They're moving
Here's
the ball.
Here's Ulisney. Defense knows he's a lefty. Oh. Looks like a foul. No foul. No call there. He got hit hard in the head. Timeout call maybe by Landon. They don't call timeout. Should have called timeout. They call timeout?
They gave him timeout?
They did? Okay, good. Yeah, that was a great call.
It was a great timeout call. I'm not sure possession was had there. That was a soft
earlier,
possession.
Earlier, when I was verbalizing a timeout call, they had it, and then they lost it, and then they called it, and then they gave it to him.
McCabe, those are the old scrums where you and I would pinpoint you, run in, and just light you up, and like because you had your eyes down looking to pick up the ground ball, and I was like, ooh, there is food for dinner. Here come.
My arm still has a mark, I think, for the last. those are the ones you don't put your arms in. I mean, you just get your arms snapped
tied to your body. Keep it tied to your body.
Defensemen look for arms, not stick. Man, that's where you usually get the shins, because you pull your arms out, you get in the shins, and then your shins are bloodied, and it's, oh, man. So it's 8-3 here with 2:47 to go. We're having a great time here. We hope you are enjoying this game at home. Don't count the Bears out. Don't count the Bears out. It's 8. I know Prep's dominating.
It's going to be a game. It's going to be a game of runs.
And Prep's heavily favored. They're favored by 4.5 unofficially.
They do two goals here, and Landon's right back in this thing.
Landon, good timeout here by McGettigan. Let's see if they come out and guard with two. Yeah, they're going double pull on the short on the middies again, and they're putting Keegan on Maddox. Maddox just got to start initiating everything now. He did a nice job on Whittier last time, and now they're going to go to him again. So they're going to go with Maddox and invert here versus Keegan. And he can get this.
Love it.
Robertson's got to get out of his way.
Great
two Maddox
step.
Is a lefty.
Great two
Breaks
step.
The stick. Back
Great
to him. Back step. To him. He's got to bear it. Oh
man.
Give it away.
Cass watched that thing from low to high. What a great shot, though. He changed planes, man. He changed planes. I think he went stick side, and that's why Cass was there.
Right in the stick. Didn't make a move.
Yeah, but it was a great shot, and way to see that the stick was broken and it hit him back.
Nice play by Ulisney to get him ball back, and then Prep clears it after the broken stick. And here goes Prep with 2 minutes to go. 2 minutes to go in the half, 8-3, and the ball. Here's Arata. With backside to Horning. First midfield out for Prep is dangerous.
They're playing loose, man.
Now Kabiri has a shorty on him after switches. Quick slide down to Larry Horning. Good save there by Zach Williamson.
That's going to hurt tomorrow.
Great body save there. I don't know if he feels that with all those pads they wear nowadays. Landon, 140, has a timeout in their pocket. Nice, smart, clear. They might have a little bit of numbers here. No, two poles. And then they got six back, so. Landon probably going to call a timeout here.
I feel like Landon needs to inch its way back. It can't be. They've got to go goal by goal by goal, right? Possessions, good shots, and goals. If they're going to try to run with prep, it can get away from them pretty quick.
Alex Mercado on short side D midi now. Steele Maddox has got to initiate on him. He's got to demand the ball at X. Here he is, right here. Inside to Murray. That was working against Cardinal Gibbons. It's not going to work against prep. Jamming the ball to the crease does not work against good defenses.
Exactly. That's 88 ball.
Yeah, you just can't do that against good defenses. All right, here's a short stick matchup for Anthony Savoy. The Denison commit and versus Tampa. Doesn't seem like he was going too hard there. Here is Welgos on Robertson. Madlack's 2024 teammates. And here they are battling. Robertson gets a step on.
Great step.
Steele Maddox backs it up.
Goal line extended, man.
Maddox
can't let him above.
Mercado on him. Look for Maddox to initiate here. No, only 7 seconds in the... So he just want to get a shot off here. He's going to go to the rack hard. Almost scores
it. Oh, wow.
Nice shot there. Saved by Cass.
That would have been an amazing one-on-one.
Good try there by Steele Maddox. And another save by Cask. Cask unofficially only has 4, but not a lot of shots by Landon. So it sounds low, but hasn't been a lot of shots.
Yeah.
8 seconds. Uh-oh. 5, 4. Great.
Whoa! We had a mugging out there. Jeez, we had a mugging.
I love
someone call 911.
I love the no call.
By the way, I love it too. Yeah. That's what I used to do. That's absolutely what I used to do.
He hugged him. He hugged him and took him down and made it look
round.
Like, made it look like he was playing
maybe
lacrosse.
A little dirt in the eye.
No lacrosse going on there.
That was good.
Oh, he shoves it inside. And that's going to do it. 8-3 at half. Quick recap on the scoring. Prep has 2 goals by Kabiri, 2 goals by Burns, and a lot of other players. We're going to take a quick break, and we'll join you back. We're going to show you some videos here, and then we'll be back to enjoy the second half.
That was fun. So.
Show me how to love. Maybe I'm going.
Welcome back here to Triplet Field at Bordley Stadium for the DMB Lacs Game of the Week. We are at halftime, wrapping up here. Showing on your screen is the top 20. As you can see, Georgetown Prep 8-2 is here live versus Landon, who has moved up to number 4 and 6-4 after their big win over Bullis. Every week you can check out the DMB Lacs top 20 on our Go Mad Lacs Instagram and also on dmblacrosse.com. Make sure on dmblacrosse.com you go there now and check out the previews for this game, the predictions, the spreads, if you so enjoy betting on high school lacrosse like my delinquent brother does. And then also make sure, if you want to follow along with the rosters, you go click on the description below the live stream production you're watching right now. All right, I'm Cabo Maddox here with Brendan Fry. Quite the active first half. Prep dominated, but in the third quarter, Landon surely got back in the game.
I absolutely agree with you. I feel like Landon came out to a good start. Things were kind of moving the way they wanted to be, kind of a low-scoring game, and then they let it get away from them a little bit, and then they fought back a little bit at the end. You know what? A couple quick goals, a couple quick face-offs here in the second half, and guess what? We're right back into a Prep-Landon rivalry game.
Yep, here's Jack Slew going out there with Carson Whittier and Luke Crow on the win.
Chip on his shoulder right there. Heading out to the
good ride by the
tundra.
Bears. Good ride by the Bears. Gets it back. Troy Lisney, great
ride.
Play. Murray
great
picks
ride,
it up.
Man. Great ride.
Over to
Coach Bowley be proud to see that right there.
Robertson. To Savoy. Prep not worried about the matchups, it doesn't seem. More so than just let's guard our guys. As evidenced there by Will Keegan. Robertson step on. Shot it right into the pocket.
Can of corn.
Easy.
Can of corn right there.
Easy
man.
Save.
That used to get guys pulled back in college.
Just no shot change location. Luke Crow step down. Ooh. Misses wide left.
He's got to start doing offensive shooting drills because he's had 3 shots and he's missed left each time.
I mean, Luke Crow's like 6'3". When he fills out of Notre Dame, he's going to be massive, excellent defender for them.
Another corn-fed Indiana country boy out there. You just want to go up against those guys.
Here's Bradshaw with AZ on him. Bradshaw straight downhill. Gets a step on. No slot. He's going to shoot it. Kicks it inside. Oh. Wide open.
Woo! Don't get caught watching the paint dry.
Landon.
He was not watching his man. Man Landon. Ball, man ball.
Landon had no second slide on that. Number 7, Owen Horning, off the feed from Rafe Bradshaw. Number 9 on a nice look. Good patience there by Rafe Bradshaw. Tampa getting a gem, 6'2", 225-pound man down at in Florida.
They're growing big these days. I mean. Yeah, that's a whole.
Landon pinch and pop.
Listen, I got to be honest. I had to battle these guys. Harmer Thompson, Taylor Simmers, Todd Eichelberger, Clay Curtis, a bunch of absolute killers.
And then for prep.
And then at prep, I mean, Danny Gladding, of course. And I don't ever root for Virginia, even though my nephew plays there. Jake Giuliani, because they got the pretty hair and the pretty uniforms. But guess what? Danny Gladding's a killer. John Paleologus, Bray Malfrus, who went on from graduating from Virginia, winning national championships to go on and defend our country.
Good.
Scotty Doyle, Georgetown, 6'3", 220. Glistening, gorgeous, running up and down the field. It was like watching Secretariat.
That's a good-looking man.
And then Johnny Bennett, the Brahma Bull, heading to Princeton. The guy, first ever prep guy to beat Landon right here on Landon's campus. We cried for 3 days. I think we went to mass after that one.
Steel Maddox draws a penalty on now. Landon goes man up. Thanks for sharing that. Those guys are all legends. There's been so many amazing players. You can't even begin to.
A great move. The defenseman comes in high, dip your shoulder. He goes right over the top, and it looks ugly, and the refs are going to call it all the time.
Another man up. There might be two men up here, and they are. 8:24 to go, 3-9. Landon's man up's been pretty good this year, but they don't seem to be getting any quality looks against the prep man down. Up to Panetti. Over to Robertson. Wacky set here, formation, I mean. I can't figure out what formation. Robertson.
High heat.
High and hard.
He was posing. He was posing for his prom date. He was posing there if you hit that.
He has one goal on the day.
Got to finish.
Looking for more. I mean, the pressure by the man down is impressive. Kicked out. They're flying. There's Lesher on the ball here on Murray. Graham Lesher, the 2024 defenseman. Maddox back to Robertson.
Here we go. Goalie's best friend.
Great shot.
Goalie's best friend.
He just ran five yards over the line.
That's pretty much offsides. That was incredibly offsides.
They got it. Took the ref a while.
Let's bring the temperature down a little bit. But they got it. You're right. I mean, that was clear as day. That was clear as day.
The young man didn't know.
I would have caught that. Yeah.
All right. Here's all even. 9-3. 7:44 to go. Landed on the extra man. Panetti just rattled it off. Panetti, one of the better attackmen in the area, junior, committed to Bucknell. Has two assists on the night. He is the leading point scorer on the team.
Here's Someone's got to put him on the shoulders right now. Someone has to say, it's on me. I'm going to literally put it on my shoulders, score a goal, make an assist, get a slide, do whatever you got to do, but finish here.
Savoy's got to get a step on Whittier here. He does. Great shot.
Good save.
But right in the stick
Another
great save.
He's got to change planes there. He went high to high, and the goalie stick was just sitting there. But he wasn't on it. He just went right to his stick.
Almost a fast break. But Owens stops the break. Good hustle there by Davis Owens. Gets it out to Larry Horning. And now prep sets up their offense. Dangerous prep offense here. Larry Horning back to Burns. Burns over to Kabiri. Has Will Cohen on him. That's the marquee matchup.
It is.
Kabiri has two goals in the day. One on a one-on-one and one on a man up.
So that sounds like a draw to me, man. Here we go.
Here's the marquee matchup. Cohen.
Get lift. Got a lift.
Season.
Wow.
That is Caden's first goal of the season.
Wow.
I'm unsure who fed him. He made a move. But I'd love to give that assist, but he did a little hitch and go.
It's a great shot.
And I see his mom down here screaming. I believe that's Caden's first goal of the season. It is his first goal of the season. Sophomore. I was starting to say these sophomores might be a little overwhelmed by this matchup and intensity, but Caden Southworth rising to the occasion, showing some toughness and grit as a young buck. You know, like, you know how prep is all seniors this year. Yeah. Landon's all juniors. Yeah. They have everyone back next year.
Year in, year out, it's going to be a battle, right? I still think this thing's going to come down to a few goal game. That's just the way these things go.
Here's Crow. It's doubled as a pole. Oh, looks like Landon's taking out a little more nervousness on the prep sideline all of a sudden. Yeah. I hear the coaches who are confident.
Coach Yard doesn't raise his voice very often, so that tells you something. There's a little
nervous energy, a little bit more nerve. They don't want Landon to get back in this game, but if they can stop him here, they might do that, and they're not going to stop him there. Kieran McCleary, the Hopkins commit, just goes one-on-one down the alley.
Hopkins, ugh, I'll root for him because of prep, but Hopkins, ugh.
10-4, McCleary. Prep doesn't send a lot to Hop, but they got Kieran.
We can't get in. We do our best. We try. Pags got in, and he had cinder block feet.
I'm gonna tell Pags you said that.
Yeah, don't worry, he's listening. Listen, side to side wasn't his best. Forward and backward.
Oh, another win. Atkins almost throws it away again. He did that earlier. Second time he got away with murder. Heavy pressure here. Two-man ride by the little Hoyas. Oh, and they have numbers here. It's 5-on-4. Prep does a nice job in transition defense to settle that down. I'm running out of paper space.
They did.
10-4.
I like a lot of action, man. For a game that I thought Landon was going to slow down, they're moving it back. They're getting up and down. They got some athletes. They just need to get a little run here. This could be it.
4 minutes to go. 10-4 prep. Landon brings out their first midfield line. Here's Robertson.
This guy looks big. Who is this guy? 11.
Chase Robertson, the Utah commit. He has one.
He likes to ski and score goals. I like that.
He went out there and, you know, he saw 20,000 blonde hair, blue eyed girls and committed.
They're all Mormons, though. You got to be careful.
No, I thought so, but great ball movement.
Oh, great save.
Another.
Run it down and shoot it. Take it. That's a goal. That's a save of the day right there.
Jack Cass, impressive save on Murray.
Great save.
And here Kelly gives it up to Owen, who settles it down. There's only 20% Mormons at Utah. It's not BYU.
Okay. Good. The odds are good then. The odds are better.
Yeah. And here is Kabiri at X. Love to see all the banners and the energy the 10-year-olds, just 11-year-olds, 12-year-olds.
It's great to be back, man. It's great to be back.
Look at all the guys in the end zone, both end zones, loaded with kids. Don't even know the score of the game.
The next generation.
Tip there by Cohen, back at X to Kabiri.
Man, you're firing the ball.
Up to Hornig. Here is Arata.
This kid's tough, man. Little cold.
Arata
gate.
Skippy. Holy smoke.
Cavill, you would have loved that goal back in the day.
That
had Cavill-matics all over it.
Oh, my
little
Lord.
Highlight.
That is
showtime. Showtime.
I couldn't even dream up all the moves this kid does. He was filmed last week.
It went viral.
He was doing a between the legs dodge. I mean, the things you can't even like dream up, he was doing, and it went mini viral last week.
Yeah. Oh, that one where he stopped and literally the guy just tripped over his feet.
Well, no, I'm talking about he actually went between the legs. McCleary. Odd pass. Oh, there's Landon shutting off someone in the back corner over there. Looks like Burns. No, it's Kabiri they're shutting off. They got Burns at X here. 5-on-4, wide open inside. Yeah. If you don't practice 5-on-4, it's not easy.
Yeah.
It's not easy. I mean,
when it's not normal, when it's not something you do normally, it's hard just to click on and off.
So that was, I think that was 7 from 0 on EMO. I got to go to page 2. Thought I was going to make it, but it was a lot of goals. We predicted a 10-9 Hoyas win. It shows you how wrong we were.
Yeah, but it's not there yet. Listen. These games, the great thing about lacrosse, make it take it, right? A little run here, and all of a sudden the pressure builds up on. But yeah, Prep's faceoff guys doing great.
Credit to Coach Urich for going out and getting number 21, Jax Liu.
Yeah.
They lost Eldridge last year, back to Virginia. They had no one in the books. that could face off. They recruited him. They put him in the boarding school, and now he's winning every face off against the Bears.
Let me tell you something. We also got to give a shout out to Brett Grant, the admissions director of Georgetown Prep. He literally, him and Coach Yurk, it's nicer probably than any hotel we've ever stayed in when we were traveling at a game.
Totally. Kick back to Quinn Coughlin, who gets hammered, and he draws the foul from Luke Krogh.
Oh, he's down.
He got driven into the mat. He's tough. He'll get up slowly. He's going to get up slowly. Pick him up, boys. Pick up your boy. Don't let him sit down there. Pick him up. There's Panetti picking him up. There you go. So man up here for Landon. 118. He's holding his face. It was a pile drive there by Crow into the mat.
Yeah.
I think Coughlin will be okay. And then, he's jogging off. He's fine, folks. And then 118 to go. Landon desperately needs a goal here. 11-4. Let's see if one of the Sport Automotive players to watch can light the lamp. Chase Robertson picking up the ball here is one of those players, as is 22, Anthony Panetti.
They got to do something here, Cavill. They got to do something here. It's been too long of a no score.
They're calling a two-minute unreleasable. They could get a couple goals here.
This could be a moment here
when we look back. Landon's man up has been pretty good this year. They need to score quickly. Over to Steele Maddox. Bad pass picked up over to Panetti. Look at the pressure. Prep looks like they're even. I mean, they look like they're even.
Boys are moving.
There's no one open.
There
wide open
is.
Inside.
Oh, that would have been super sweet. But yeah. He was open. It's just a little late.
52 seconds. They need to score one here before the quarter end. Panetti way outside.
Wow.
That's not the best shot
totally
you can
ate it
get
up.
Right
Cask
there.
Ate it up, man. Didn't even get into his body.
Great save by Cask. Yeah. I got seven
there
for
was
him.
There's some heat there.
Seven for him, and they're man down. It's not releasable, I don't think. 30 seconds in the quarter, a minute and a half in the penalty, minute and 10. They got a 2 minute, pretty sure it's unreleasable. I didn't check the unreleasable sign, but here goes Landon on the double. And Kabiri's gonna run for his life. Good back check, stripped. Good takeaway check there by Davis Owens, number 13.
Great takeaway check.
Four seconds to go. They're going to tell him to hold it so they don't lose possession. Oh my gosh. What is the delay on the whistle? Oh my gosh, these refs. WALOA refs, usually the best, Bobby Manfuso and his crew. But you don't give them 30 seconds to set up the ride.
Ooh.
And then they get a hack after the whistle. They call it.
They got a little action.
Then there's a little extracurricular.
Do you guys get that? You attackmen love to get a little piece when we're running up the field. Little edge of the elbow right there. The little funny bone.
Did you see the thing? We want to thank Surfside for being a sponsor here. The official post-game party after the game. Make sure you head down to Surfside, Tenleytown, D.C. You looking for the perfect post-game hangout spot? Look no further than Surfside. With their comfortable outdoor seating, multiple TVs, and free parking, you can enjoy the best tacos in D.C. while relaxing after the game. We'll see you there. Special thanks goes out to our guy and Surfside owner, Bo Blair, Georgetown Prep 89.
Scholar and a gentleman.
For his support of DMV Lax. And again, if you tell him you hate Landon, you might get a free drink at Surfside.
You probably do.
At least a taco.
You probably do. I mean, it'll be real liquor, but you'll get a free drink.
Back at you here, quick timeout, quick quarter end here, 11-4. Landon is still man up, has the ball. They have to clear it, and they got to get at least one, hopefully two, in this man up opportunity, a 2 minute opportunity on the.
They need a couple here.
Unnecessary, yeah.
They need a couple here. It's amazing how momentum begets momentum, right? They get a couple here, all of a sudden the crowd's into it, the comeback, and all of a sudden face-offs happen, and this is the great thing about lacrosse. Make it take,
totally.
and that's how runs happen, that's how these great games finish up. And that's how I thought this was gonna happen today, and it still might. We got 12 minutes left. love to see another epic battle of Prep and Landon on the 35th anniversary of the first one.
All right, ball's going to start with Will Cohen, number four, back left on your screen here. Just a regular nine-man ride. They're not going to do a 10-man. I thought they'd come out of the box with a 10-man.
Yeah, I think with all the goals scored from long distance this year, it's the death of the 10-man ride.
Everyone's doing 10-mans this year. It's incredible. Wow. Here's Zach Abramson up to Nico Schirmer. Nico's got easy pass right in front of himself. Up to Robertson, who's got Welgos on him. Back to Steele Maddox. Down to Maddox. Maddox looks inside. No, he doesn't. Inside, open. Murray.
Oh.
Murray caught it with his right. If he'd had it lefty there, it was a tough play.
It was tough
play.
Turn. It was
That's a tough play. Down to Lisney, and we're all even. All even. So, oh my lord.
That pass. It's like Deion Sanders. Here we go.
Carson Whittier takes a blast. It stays Prep on the backup by Burns.
As an old defenseman, took a shot every time I had the chance. I kind of love it, but he should have given that up. Great back check there
by Davis Owens. Inbounds, sleeping. Davis Owens outruns the ride. Has a break down to Ferguson. Ferguson's going to let it go. Pask is on point tonight.
He's on point. He's on point. I mean, there's been a couple in the stick, but he's on point. And he's seeing the ball.
That was another low to high like Steele Maddox's earlier. But
he's got the confidence now. He's seeing the ball.
You got to go low to low on him or something.
Yeah. They got to change planes. They got to change planes. It's got to be fast, and they got to change planes.
Well, he loves the low to highs. That doesn't even bother him at all.
Yeah, he definitely stays hot. He definitely stays up. He doesn't drop the knees. He stays up. That's what you want a goalie to be, fearless in there.
Tommy Rada with Christian Damute on him. Good slide there by Eli Smink. Over to Owen Horner with Ferguson on him. Quick jab step. Gets. It's incredible to me that Burns and Kabiri are going to Princeton together.
Yeah.
I mean, they play so well off each other, and
they do.
And then they're gonna add.
They play with a confidence, though. And the thing about it is how do you carry on that confidence from senior year to freshman year through college, right? You get up there, everyone's a little faster.
Yeah, they're not gonna play.
Was the best player on their team, and you got to continue that level of confidence in yourself.
Yeah, and it probably won't even play as fast. Yeah. I don't even know what Princeton has on the roster, but they see if he wanted to. He's only a sophomore.
Yeah,
probably a redshirt freshman. Here's Chase Robertson, kicks it back to Steele Maddox. Steele Maddox triple team, double team, triple team, double team.
Man.
And a triple team. He still has it. Yeah. Draws a foul.
Draws a foul.
Tough play by Maddox. Back check by Kelly. Over to Hank Maddox. Hank, his brother, is in now. Up to Davis Owens, and they settle it down. Man, that was a tough play by Steele.
Tough
he had four or five guys on him. Ball movement here. What is that shot?
You can't. I mean, they had the penalty, but.
Was there a shot clock? Was there a shot clock opportunity? Oh.
It might have been, but you're right. You can't give the goalie pure vision on your shot and not even change it, no matter how hard you shoot the ball.
That is just wrong. That is just wrong. All right, here we go. Man up, Landon. Good to see they're keeping. Looks like they're going. Hank in on man up now. Steele, Maddox, back to Ulisney. There must have been a shot clock delay. I can't excuse Troy first taking that shot.
Had to have been.
So we're going to say there was no time on the clock.
Yeah, no screen.
Maddox, Dak, over to Hank.
Man,
Maddox.
Do you agree? Prep's man down is aggressive.
I mean, they seem like they have six the whole time.
I agree, man. They're all over the place. Ball gets there, and they're there.
Hank Maddox over to... Double cuts. Hank Maddox inside.
Wow.
Checked
great
it by
stick. That's Jake. Caught at Mad. That's taught at Madlax right there. Great stick.
Great Picked job by Welgos. Ryan Welgos, the Nova commit. A little bit of a force inside. Bounces out. They're still man up for 8 more seconds. 11-4 here. 7:40 to go in the fourth quarter. Nico Schirmer, aggressive three-sport athlete at Landon. Committed to Bowden, up to Kabiri, and they're going to kill the penalty, and they're all even, up 11-4. So that's another man up.
Two minutes. 2 minutes.
McCleary over to Bradshaw. Has AZ on him. Kicks him down to the backside. Nice defense. Back to Smink, with Horning on him. McCleary, just looking smooth. He's a smooth Badger.
Yes.
I can see why.
It is. You know, you just said it's silky, right?
Yeah.
You think it doesn't look fast, but then he gets open, you know?
He's long, too. He's probably 6'2", maybe. And he's going to fill out and be a big boy at Hop. Hop having an incredible year. I know you hate him, yep. But that was, oh, what a hit by Steel Maddox. Completely legal. That is a soft call.
First of all, absolutely, absolutely, man. Come on, guys. Let him play. Let him do it on the field. That's a soft, soft call.
I mean, he got him. Steel Maddox just dropped that boy. And the prep coaches are laughing at how bad it was.
Yeah.
I mean, that is as soft as it gets right there. Great ride there by Steel. And Landon coaches are arguing. Prep coaches are laughing.
They're just whipping it around, man.
And now Prep back at offense again gets a fresh 80, 60, whatever it is. Good double by Nico. Double. Nico's playing like a man, yeah.
Double. Rafe was like, whoa, back it out, back it out.
Here's Horning. He's got a short stick on here. He's an attackman. Owen Horning might be the best Dodger on this Prep team. He is the quickest steps.
Tommy
Arata.
Tommy Arata.
Nice knockdown by Eli Smink.
Reminds me of Merrill Turnbull, a crease attackman, garbage goal guy, literally just tough
I think Tommy has the quicks. He's got the quicks. Here's Owens.
Yeah, Merrill didn't have the quicks.
All right, Landon brings out the second line. Here's Caden. He has a goal on the day, his first of the season. He's going to look to get two. We're setting up Devin Stewart, number 25, for this dodge down the alley versus Javinsky.
Yeah.
Good up pick there by Steel Maddox with a short stick. Now Steel has a short. He's got to get the ball out of his stick.
Yeah.
He's still learning. He's still learning the game.
I can tell. He's an absolute athlete. He will be a killer, but he's got to. He's got to get the stick work going.
Hasn't scored much this year, I'm not sure, but he's figuring it out. And here's Panetti at X. Steel Maddox has a short, brings it up. He should blast that.
Fire it.
Man, I don't know why he went to his offhand. Yeah, he's still trying to figure it out. Yeah. You just got to catch that right and shoot the ball.
Change planes, 100 miles an hour, let it go.
That looks like a foul.
That's a foul.
Steel's drawn about five fouls today.
That's a foul, absolutely. Guys on the ground, let him get up.
Keegan with the cross check.
But let's be honest, I mean, Prep hasn't paid the price for Landon being on man up. Steel has gotten all these fouls and they got to finish.
Yeah, I mean, right? they have 0 for 0 on man up.
And that's the difference right now in the game. Those man ups, they got to finish.
I have Landon for 4 minutes. One of them was a 2-minuter and they had 0. Conversely, Prep has 3 and had 2 goals on 1 man up.
Yeah, a soft man up.
That was early in the game. That was kind of like changed the tune of the game.
It did.
If you look back, that kind of...
It did, because that was the rally.
It got loose at that point, yeah. All right, Landon comes out in a 1-4-1 formation in the man up. New formation, see if they can get a new goal. How about a goal? Looks a little better, actually. Prep just doesn't lay back on the man. Look at they cover you all over the field.
I agree.
There's got to be someone out of position. I don't understand how they can guard you that much all the way around and not be overloaded. That's a nice play.
And pass. He attacked that with his lead foot. That's what you teach goalies. That's what Quint taught kids. I mean, Charlie Toomey, that's what you teach. Attack with your lead foot. Great stop.
Nine saves for Jack Kask unofficially.
Yeah. Yeah. That one caught him in the hip. I can see.
4 minutes to go here. Thanks for joining us. Stick with us here. This you never know in Landon Prep. I'm Cabell Maddox here with Brendan Fry. It's been an amazing day.
It's been an awesome day, Cabell. Thank you so much for having me. Old times, attackman and defenseman going at it. So fun to be here with you. Thank you.
Yeah, this has been great. You've been awesome. And we're not done yet. We still have a lot to get to. Georgetown Prep. Dodge there by Tommy Arata down the alley. Misses left. 3:30 to go. 11-4. Landon's just got to keep grinding here. I mean, what do you estimate the crowd here? Maybe two? I mean, it's so spread out. Like, you know, they have guys on each end, 2,000, maybe 1,500. Beautiful crowd, beautiful day. A lot of pregame parties, and the postgame party is still to come. And as we say that, Larry Horning is having a party. 12-4. Now they're just playing for a little bit of pride and bragging rights. This game is well over.
Finish it off. You're going to see each other in the playoffs most likely. Finish it off on a good note.
Yeah, hopefully everyone stays clean. No penalties, no hoopla. Here's Will Keegan. Back to Burns, over to Kabiri. You think Uric will call timeout and put in the bench, or just doesn't do that in the landing?
You know, it's fun. No, I hope he would, because this is a special moment, and also especially since you've got 21 seniors this year, and you got guys who you're going to need next year to lead this program. I hope he does put some of these guys in and give them a little taste of this environment.
And also, you got guys who you need in the bullets, and they call a loose ball. It was a loose ball, so they're calling a foul. I guess they're going to go with possession push. But it was a loose ball, so it should be just a loose ball push. But that ref over there is giving it a 30-second push call. Landon goes man down. Prep goes man up. Start thinking about
at 12-4, I probably let that push go and say, let's give these guys a chance to pick up the ground ball and continue going.
Let's start thinking about the Surfside.
Yes, absolutely.
MVP.
Absolutely.
MVP. They are sponsoring the MVP award. We don't have to just award it now. I just want you to start thinking about it. But I'd like to definitely give the MVP from Prep, and then maybe an honorable mention of a player from Prep and Landon.
Absolutely. So I agree with you. I personally, because this is so important to Prep, right? And it's important to Landon too, but this rivalry is so important. There's 21 seniors on this team. I would love to give it to the seniors, right? And I know we can give it to one person, absolutely. But these seniors are going to walk off here today after getting beat 6-5 last year, having a bad taste in their mouth, and saying, we're not going to let it happen this year.
Good save there by Abramson. So that's his fifth unofficially. So Burns has 4 points, two and two.
Well, Burnsy, of course, Kabiri.
Kabiri has three goals and zero assists, or 3 points.
I think actually Jack Cass.
Jack Cass, nine saves.
He just caught a 90-mile-an-hour one in the hip.
Oh, and that picked off there by six.
That's a night ruiner.
And it looks like they're subbing. So Seamus McNally is in, and Prep's starting to
put some other guys
put
in.
Which is good to see. Good. Here's McNally right here.
Let him get him
McNally. Senior attackman out there. 1 minute to go. That's going to do it because the shot clock doesn't even have more than the game clock. Landon brings out some D-middies that haven't played here. That's Nico. That's Riley Luger out there on defense. And Prep will probably just hold it. And the Landon coaches will likely show some class and just tell them not to guard.
100%. 100%.
43 seconds in the game.
Two teams are going to see each other again.
12-4 is going to be your score. I don't think that Prep will shoot. I think they'll probably roll it out. So, are we leaning towards Jack Cask as MVP of the game?
I think Cask, because I think that
he's got his helmet up back here. You can't see him on camera, but he looks like a Canuck.
That stop early in the game, confidence, that literally defense goes, all right, we got you. I know as a defenseman, when your goalie makes a save like that early on, you can give up a shot here and there, and you're not going to be in trouble.
What defenseman on the field impressed you today?
I mean, I love Crow. I love Crow. I think he's wiry. He's fast.
Yeah.
I love Isaiah Rose. That's the guy who's going to protect our country. That's the guy you want protecting our country. He's just an incredible young man. So I think this is a great win for Prep. But guess what? Season's not over. We're going to see each other again, and it'll be another battle in a couple weeks.
All right. So you agree that we should give the MVP to Jack Cass?
I think so.
Let's give it to Jack Cass. Congratulations, Jack. The pride of Coquitlam, British Columbia, Canada. He gets the MVP award honors, and we give an honorable mention to Kabiri and Burns.
Yes.
And for Landon, maybe Davis Owens, the long stick midfielder. I thought he played a great game.
I got to be honest, I thought Steele drew a bunch of fouls, played hard, it was a tough game out there. Guys were all over, so you tell me, but kid's a tough kid.
It was a battle. I think that early on it was too much. We want to thank our sponsors again, Sport Automotive and Surfside. But now the Surfside Game MVP officially goes to Jack Cass. And we would like to invite everyone down to Surfside for the official after party here. Probably going to start as soon as we get out of here. It's going to be a mess getting out of here.
Pretty quick. It's going to be a great afternoon, evening.
We'll be down at Surfside shortly. Maybe we'll rewatch the game live on the big screen. All the prep alums can bask in the glory of this big win down at Surfside, DC, and Tenleytown.
I'm heading to a Boy Child pre-party right now. I got to go take pictures. Cabell,
thanks again.
It's an honor being here with you.
Thanks for joining me, Brennan. And we'll do it again.
I'll do it again.
Sport Automotive, thank you very much for sponsoring the Players to Watch. And look forward to having both Sport Automotive and Surfside involved for the rest of the year. I'm Cabell Maddox signing off, and thanks for joining us here today. Go to video.